Fifth the Psychic, coming back at you again with another video. Okay, people, now let me say this before we even get into this discussion. People, I know they're going to be Nadal fans and Federer fans and total different tennis fans that's not Nadal fans or Federer fans that's going to take this totally out of proportion. They're going to turn it into the GOAT debate, Nadal versus Federer. And you know what? Hey, that's okay. I mean, that'll make the channel even better, but that's not really my intention here. But I just want to throw that out. I mean exactly what the title question. Using the eye test. Okay, the eye test means just that's not statistics. You don't have to look at any statistics. Using your eyes. I mean your eyes, your physical eyes. Now maybe using your eyes over a period of time, over a period of years. Which one between Nadal and Federer? Who passes the eye test between those two for being the GOAT? Like, if you came from another planet, and let's say you saw Nadal over here on the court, and you saw Nadal at his highest level on the court, and you saw Federer at his highest level on the court, which one of them passed the GOAT test? Just on eyes alone. You don't know how many slams the guy have. You don't know... How you say this? You don't know how many Masters Series the guys have won. You don't know who's been number one the longest. You don't know any of that stuff. You don't know who's won the most French Opens. Only thing is, and let's say this right here. You have a chance not just to watch somebody one time. You can watch videos, okay? Like I say, you ain't gonna see any stats. You can watch 10 years, 10 to 12 years. They will show you as many videos as possible of Nadal at his highest level and Federer at his highest level. I had to change that analogy because you know why? If I wanted to change that analogy, some commenter would have said this right here. They would say, well, I've seen Monfils in one match where you can say in one match he looked like he was the GOAT. Okay? So that's why I said if you had to watch these guys over 10 to 12 years, and also Monfils hasn't won any majors, so you're going to actually see these guys win majors though. Okay? All right. So which one of them passed the eye test as far as the GOAT? Okay, now I'm going to give y'all my opinion and tell you which one of them I think passed the eye test and who I would choose, who I think is probably the GOAT based on just the eye test. Okay, people, but let me just talk about the eye test. Those of you who don't know what the eye test means, it means just what it says. It means when you use your eyes, you say, this is the GOAT. Or this looks GOAT something, okay? People, let me say something, people. Y'all know in the NBA, there's been that debate. It's really heated up the last couple months. It sort of cooled down now that LeBron James lost in the final. I don't think it makes LeBron James any less. But it's Michael Jordan versus LeBron James. Who's the GOAT? And a lot of people say, there are a lot of people that say, we don't need to look at LeBron James' stats. And LeBron James got stats that has surpassed Michael Jordan because he's played longer. He got Michael Jordan beat in the longevity stuff, and he got Michael Jordan beat in some other stats. But people say no, we don't want to hear that. When people say we use the eye test, we going with Michael Jordan. If you ask people, even the people, I even know a friend that say, well, LeBron James, he got more achievements than Michael in some areas. But this same guy said, I say, well, who will you want on your team? Tell me the truth. He said he was honest. He was honest enough to say this. He said, I'm taking Michael Jordan. So people, when they use the eye test, now I'm not saying Michael do have stats that LeBron James haven't surpassed yet, but LeBron James could surpass those just because he's playing longer. But people, when they compare LeBron James to Michael Jordan, a lot of people, even though LeBron, listen, LeBron James, when you look at LeBron James by himself, with his size and speed and the things LeBron James can do, he does look GOAT something. eye test wise. But when you put them right beside Michael Jordan, go back and look at Michael Jordan highlights or games, most people say we're going with Michael Jordan based on just the eye test. We don't care. There are people that say that. We don't care if LeBron James passed Michael Jordan. There are some people that say we know who's better. We know who's the greater one based on the eye test, okay? So I sort of mean it that way. So now let's get back to Nadal versus Federer with the eye test. Now, people, let me just say this first of all. Now, I'm giving y'all my personal opinion now. And my tennis channel opinion, and this is my personal opinion. Which my personal opinion is usually in line with my tennis channel opinion. They're really the same. People, both of these guys passed the eye test for being the GOAT, okay? Federer passed it long time ago. I mean, Federer pretty well. As far as the eye test, people, before Federer broke Pete Sampras' record, people already were saying, Federer's this look GOAT something. This guy's gonna be the greatest of all time. He just needs to get the achievements. So, but as far as the eye test, people were already saying this is the best they ever seen. People was already saying that Federer was the best they ever seen. Okay, even before he broke Pete Sampras's record. So Federer sorta he already passed the eye test for being the GOAT long time ago. Now somebody may be asking a question. Well, Magic Man, are you saying that a person that needs a player like Nadal or Federer, if they pass the eye test for being the GOAT, that makes them the GOAT? No, it doesn't. But I think that if you just ask me, now this is subjective. This whole video is subjective. So y'all don't take it too. Don't get too out of whack over this. People, I do think the eye test, like if I was, I think the eye test counts for like almost 35% of whether a player is the GOAT, okay? People, the Djokovic, he passed the eye test for the GOAT. You know that thing, those videos I did where people, I told y'all back in 2013, 2014, people were saying that Djokovic looked like the best ever. That means he passed the eye test. Now, did he pass the achievement test as far as stats? No, he didn't pass that. He didn't live up to that. He got injured, and plus he started tripping. Whatever went wrong in his personal life, and it affected his game. And now we have the Djokovic where he is now. He didn't become the GOAT. Now, people, let me say this here. Both Nadal and Federer passed the eye test. I know y'all would wait. Well, imagine, man, you just said you skipped Nadal and you said something about the Djokovic passed the eye test, and we ain't even talking about him. What about Nadal? People, listen. Nadal, whether you think, even Federer fans probably agree with this. They ain't gonna say Nadal's the GOAT, but if I ask Federer fans, do you think he passed the eye test for being the GOAT though? That don't mean he's the GOAT, but at least in that category, okay, Nadal got to surpass Federer as far as majors. But the first thing is, does he surpass Federer as far as the eye test? He's definitely equal, people. Okay, I'm gonna tell you that right now. Now, what I thought was funny, people, y'all know when I was in that, those of you probably who was keeping up with the comment section, y'all, I was in a fierce argument. When I cut it off, I blocked the guy from my channel. He's a fake Nadal fan. He's what you call one of those internet trolls. He actually called me a moron. So I blocked him from the channel. Whatever his name is, I don't even want to know his name because I don't like internet trolls anyway. That's a waste of time on my channel. I usually block them, and definitely the racist ones. Okay, I definitely gonna block them. But I blocked them from my channel because, okay, not that people, now y'all can disagree with me all day. I'm not gonna block somebody from my channel. That's not good. That's not freedom. That's blocking freedom of speech. That's why I look at that. But I mean, as long as a person don't get like personal with me, and I'm not gonna get personal, so calling somebody names or something like that. I'm talking about calling somebody, not saying somebody's silly, but actually calling somebody a name. But people, this internet troll, this fake who claimed to be a Nadal fan, y'all remember I told y'all that in the 2017 Nadal that beat Wawrinka, not just me people, even the Dow fans, like those the Dow fans, like Tennis Rules, Melvin Marshall, I don't know where they was at a couple of days ago. I was hoping they were going to come to the rescue and put this internet troll who's claiming to be a Nadal fan. This Melvin Marshall and Tennis Rules has said many times to me, Magic, do you see what Nadal did to Wawrinka last year? That's the highest level ever seen on a court. People, John McEnroe and Patrick McEnroe said that just wasn't probably the highest level Nadal ever played on clay. They saying that the way Nadal beat Wawrinka, that was one of the highest levels ever seen on the court, if not the highest, on all surfaces. Okay? So people, what I'm saying is that to me, that passed the eye test for the GOAT. As far as Nadal. Now, does Nadal have to surpass Federer for me to put... does Nadal have to surpass Federer as far as majors for me to put Nadal over Federer? Of course. And maybe some other categories. Like, Federer's been in so many finals and semifinals. But as far as the eye test, people, Nadal has passed the eye test for the GOAT. Like, if you came from another planet and somebody said Nadal's the GOAT, you ain't gonna debate them if you see the way what he did to Wawrinka. Listen, people, forget that. When Nadal beat Federer in 2008, people wasn't saying, this is the GOAT, this is the GOAT, this look like the GOAT. No. People said, oh, Nadal beat Federer on his own turf. Federer is still having problems with Nadal. That's what people were saying. They didn't say Nadal looked like the GOAT. But people, after Nadal beat Wawrinka in 2017, people were saying, including myself, I said that looked GOAT something. And people, y'all remember I said that the Djokovic, he had the highest level I ever seen on the surface. I will have to say this time that Nadal for that day, that level was equivalent to the Djokovic highest level. Now the Djokovic may have gone up there high many more times than Nadal, but that day Nadal's level was as high as the highest the Djokovic level, the way he beat Wawrinka. And so that passed the eye test as far as I'm concerned. Okay, now, so you said Magic Man, well now, here's the more complicated thing. Who passes the eye test? Between, if we put Federer and Nadal beside each other, put the courts right beside each other, if you came from another planet, will you take that highest level that Nadal played against a Wawrinka? Okay. Now somebody can say, well, that was just one match. So I would say, yeah, but that's included. But let's say Nadal's highest level, not just against Wawrinka. Y'all can take 2008 if you want to go by that far, but I wouldn't go by that far. I think you should take some of those matches like that Nadal played against the Djokovic, like that 6-hour Australian Open. That passes the eye test for the GOAT. So compare that high-level Nadal against a high-level Federer. Now, some people going to do this here. They're going to compare, like, the styles. Like, people going to say, well, I like Federer's style better, and he looks smoother, and that style probably lasts longer than Nadal's style, and Nadal's style is not as pretty as Federer. That's not what I'm even asking. I'm saying, just because Nadal's style don't look as smooth as Federer style, even though Nadal's smoother than people think he is, okay? But that don't mean that he couldn't pass the eye test for being the GOAT, okay? So let me try to answer this. And this is subjective, people, okay? So if I came from another planet, and I saw Nadal's highest level. I know Nadal's highest level. And I already told y'all about the Wawrinka match, too. Okay. And that looks GOAT. That's GOAT, man. Now listen, man. I don't know who I would choose. I probably shouldn't try to choose this. But then if I saw Federer's highest level, well, like I said, the Federer swag and Federer just walking around. Y'all know that's Federer's highest level. He doesn't even have to run. He got that swag. He making it look easier than Nadal. Even though Nadal, yeah, he's a tougher player. He looks tougher than Federer. He looks like the Mike Tyson that can beat you down, get everything back. Yet Federer is over here so fluid, so this is no problem in the world. Which one of those people would I, who would I think would be the GOAT? Man, Jesus. Okay. I'm going to tell y'all, people, I already told y'all, Nadal passes the eye test for the GOAT. Okay. And now somebody say, who do you think Magic Man is the GOAT? Which one of them do you think will, which one of them you think got the most majors? And both of them have been playing for over 15 years, okay? And let's say, I don't know the age of Federer too, okay? I don't know the age, okay? Okay, people, I'm gonna just tell y'all now, the only reason why I'm gonna choose Federer, okay, the only reason why I'm gonna, listen, it's a toss-up. Nadal passes the eye test, so Nadal fans, I'm already saying Nadal, he look as GOAT as Federer from the eye test standpoint. But the only reason I'm gonna take Federer that, I probably think Federer's game would last a longer time than Nadal's. Which Nadal can still play a long time, even with injuries. He showed, even Nadal fans thought Nadal would be gone by this time, but he's still been around. So I probably would guess that Federer, he's probably the GOAT because he's probably able to, because he walks around the court with the swag and he making it look easy. And have y'all ever seen somebody in a fight? Like Nadal would just beat somebody down in a fight, okay? That's an eye test for a best fighter. But then you can have another guy, he got his hand behind his back and the guy still can't hit him. I saw that in a street fight one time. And he was laughing at the guy and he was tapping the guy side of the head and the guy was swinging at him. And this dude, he beat the guy with one hand, making it look easy, like a Federer would probably do at his highest level. So I would only take Federer, that probably I would say this guy that can sort of put his hands behind his back and walk around the court and make it look easy, even though that other guy, the Dow, can beat you down it worse than Federer. The Dow guy can beat you down just as bad as Federer can, or worse. And scary. He may look even scarier than Federer. But this Federer guy, you know, that type of game of just making it look easy, he's probably got more majors than that other guy. That's probably what I would say. Okay, people, so tell me what y'all think, y'all. And this is subjective, so people don't even, it ain't really nothing to argue about. Because I just saying that. Let me say this, because I know somebody going to comment, and they going to, for some reason, I already said this 1,000 times. Nadal, he does pass the eye test for being the GOAT. And his eye test for being the GOAT is equal with Federer's. But I said, if I just had to choose and I came from another planet and I looked at both of them and they asked me, who do you think got more majors or who's the greatest? I probably would just go with Federer because I would think he would last longer. Just with the making it look easy type fighting. Instead of the brutal beatdown type fighting. Okay? Tennis preacher, tennis prophet, tennis psychic. Have a good one.
Ha 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 ha!